Good day, team. Today we are going to discuss about the contractor selection criteria or the competency of a contractor. To those who are doing IGC or who are doing ICC, that is a construction certificate, or international general certificate, or general certificate, international construction certificate, or national construction certificate. You get it? There's a section which talks about contractor selection criteria or competency of a contractor. You get it? So the tricky behind is the contractor selection criteria. It is found in the module of IGC, the first IGC. They talk of contractor selection criteria. And then if you are doing construction, if you are now on the construction part, that is the module 2 part, or the construction module part, there is a competence of a contractor. So the secret behind is these two things are the same. You get it? On the other module, they call it contractor selection criteria. In the other module, they call it competence of a contractor. Meaning to say, if you are doing construction certificate, if you master this in the IG contractor selection criteria, when you go to the construction part, remember that it's actually the same. You get it? It's actually the same. In most cases, of course, when they ask you, they'll ask you in a tricky way, but it's actually the same. You get it? So, what are we saying? How are we going to easily remember, or how can we unpack it so that it then becomes easy for you? The best way to understand the contractor selection criteria without you cramming is, if you are able to develop a safety file, then the contractor selection criteria or the competence of your contractor is actually easy for you. The thing that are inside the safety file is actually the same. But do not confuse yourself, because in the construction there's a section that talks of the safety file, which has got some content that is there. But in this case, I'm just saying an ordinary safety file that you submit to the client. If you know how to develop a safety file, then you are able to know everything that is required on the contractor selection criteria. What are we saying? We are saying on the contractor selection criteria or the competence of a contractor, they want she policy. It's actually there on the contractor selection criteria as well as the competence of a contractor. But in this case now, because we want to use a certain aptinic, she policy is also a document that is in our ordinary safety file that we develop as practitioners and submit to the client. We are supposed to put the she policy. Procedures. Or operative procedures. It is actually part of the competency that is required from the contractor or contractor selection criteria. But then these documents are also there in our she policy. You get it? Competence. Competence. We are saying the competence is also there in the she file, which is actually part and parcel of what is required in as far as the contractor selection criteria as well as the competence of a contractor is concerned. Competence of what? We are saying competence of the team that is going to be on the ground. In your safety file, you normally submit the CVs of your safety officer, the CVs of the key personnel that is going to be on the ground, or the skeleton that is going to be on the ground. You get it? So we say competency, you get it? Or experience of the people that are going to be on the ground. You get it? And then we also need certification. with the professional bodies. Certification with the professional bodies. We are saying we need the certificate. For example, it could be probably the ISO certificate. You get it? In the SHE file, it's also the certification with what? With professional bodies. And then we also talk of insurance. Insurance, you get it? In the C file, insurance also it's also part of what is actually required by the what on the contractor selection criteria as well as the competence. And then you also go on to the references. References from the previous probably project that you have conducted. You get it? It is actually very important that you also provide the reference. And then you also have SHE costing. SHE costing is actually there even in the safety file, the SHE budget. It's actually a document that is also needed on the competence of the contractor or contractor selection criteria. Medicals. You get it? So these are some of the points or requirements of a contractor selection criteria or competence of the what? Competence of the contractor. So in short, now we are saying if you are able to develop a safety file, then you should be able to articulate the contractor selection criteria as well as the competence of a contractor. Remember, contractor selection criteria and the competence of a contractor, it's actually one and the same thing. The only issue here is it's actually found in two different modules. You get it? But the tricky behind or the secret is it's actually one and the same thing. If you are able to develop a SHE file, then you are able to articulate. You need to check, you get it, to say these things, are there these things in that, you get it? You will realize that it's actually the same. So there's no need for you to say, I need to go and read, the contractor selection criteria or SHE competence. If you know how to develop, the safety file, that information that you normally put on the content page of a safety file, these are actually the things that will be inside your safety file that you submit. And these are actually the points that are also required in as far as the contractor selection criteria as well as the competence of your contractor is concerned. You get it? Sharp. Thank you so much.